The Colouring Book. Hello, Pocoyo. What are you doing?
My book.
You're reading a book? What a great idea. Look, it has a red apple, a red car, a red ladybug, and a heart that is...
red.
Oh, look, and a red Pocoyo.
No, Pocoyo blue.
Are you sure? No, Pocoyo, it's yellow, like you.
Yellow! Elly!
Hello, Elly.
Elly, yellow! Yellow light book.
Yes, Elly. Pocoyo has a magic book, and when you turn the pages, everything changes color. What a great idea, Elly. Let's find Pato.
Yes, Pato!
Hello, Pato.
Pato!
Perhaps we should explain to Pato that thanks to the book, everything will now be blue.
Blue.
Oh, you look like a blueberry with a beak. I think you should look at yourself in the mirror. But Pato, it's a lovely blue. Well, you're right there. A duck should be duck yellow. Or green. To be fair, it's a very pretty colour, don't you think? Oh dear. Elly says it's her turn with the book.
No.
Orange. What a lovely colour for an elephant.
Mine. Purple.
I'm afraid Elly and Pato are not very happy with that colour. Guys, guys! But how many colours are there in that book?
My book! Gimp!
Oops! Oh dear! When you put the book away, the light went out! No! The colours have changed! Let's see, Pocoyo, can you think how to solve this? I meant by sharing the book.
No! My book.
Come on, Pocoyo. Just think, if you share the book, perhaps the colours will be fixed. Oh, maybe not. And here we go again. Finally! Look, Elly, you're back to pink. Oh dear. The colours are all mixed up. You're right, Pato. It's about time to get your colour back. Ah, guys, you've lost your colour.
Colour?
Oh no, the whole book is blank. We'll never see Ellie's pink or Pato's yellow or the lovely blue of...
Idea!
Pocoyo, you've had an idea. Great idea, Pocoyo. But do you think it will work? Yes, it worked. It worked.
Yeah.
Oh dear. Hooray for books and hooray for a colourful friendship. Goodbye. See you next time.
There's Pocoyo. Hello.
Hi.
Oh, what lovely toys and what lovely colours they are. What is it, Pocoyo? Do you see something else? Oh my goodness, what is that you found, Pocoyo? That looks interesting.
Buttons!
Yes, why not? Give it a go. Press a button. Let's see what happens. Look at that! Your train has turned red! Look at that! Oh, I wonder what is making the colours change. Do you know, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo? What do you think he's doing to make things change colour?
Pressing the buttons!
Yes, I think you're right. When Pocoyo presses the buttons on that toy, the colours change. Ooh, try pressing a different button, Pocoyo. Yes, it is the toy. It changes the colours of things. Amazing. All the blocks have turned red.
Yay!
And a new colour for the radio. Wow! Careful, Pato. Oh!
Oh! Oh dear! Oops!
Colors, colors!
Oh dear!
Colors.
Do be careful, Pocoyo. Pocoyo, Pocoyo, Pocoyo. Are you having fun changing colours? Yes. And do you think everyone else is having fun too? Really? Would you like to turn things back to normal, Pocoyo? Well, I'm sure we can do that. We just need to remember what everyone's proper colour is. Can any of you help Pocoyo? Why don't you shout out when Pocoyo gets it right? Go ahead, Pocoyo. Try out some colours. First, what colour is Pato? Pink?
No!
Blue?
No!
Yellow?
That's it!
Pato's yellow!
Yes, and let's see who else. Oh, yes, yes, Elly. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what colour Elly ought to be? Is it yellow?
No!
Blue?
No!
Pink!
She's pink!
Yes, she's pink, of course. Whew, I think that just about does it. What is it, Pato? What's wrong? Oh, dear. Pato's hat still isn't the right colour. Do you see, Pocoyo? Great work, Pocoyo. And great work, everyone. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Pocoyo and Elly and Pato.
Hi!
What's that you're playing?
Marbles.
Let's see. You need to get your marble into that small hole right there in the middle, right? And how is everyone doing? What about you, Pocoyo? That's a special black super marble. Oh, I'm sorry, Pocoyo. You almost had it. Well, whose turn is it now? Wait! What's happening? Yes, Pocoyo, but how did your marble move all on its own? I think you've discovered a black hole. It'll suck up anything nearby. And you know what that means, don't you? Thank you. Pocoyo. This is no time for dancing. Now come on, get away from that hole. Good idea, Pato. Grab that tree. Hold on, everyone. This is rather funny, isn't it? But I'm afraid we have to get Elly out somehow. Can anyone switch on the light? Well, that's a relief. Everything seems to be fine, except for one minor detail. All the colors are reversed. Pato, you're not yellow anymore. Now you're purple. And Elly, now you're green. You'd like everything to go back to normal, wouldn't you? Well, maybe there's a way. Are you thinking about how to get back to your world, Pocoyo? Well, you know, maybe your black super marble is the key. Maybe it can take you back home. Yes, Elly, that's it. In this world, Pocoyo's black marble would be white. Now what? There you go, a white hole. Jump in, everyone. But Pato, don't you want to be yellow again? This certainly isn't your world. You're all made of paper. You'd better find that marble. Good job, Pato. Oh my, your balloons now. Phew. You're back home, guys. You didn't leave anything behind, did you? That's a good question, Pato. What should you do with it?
Uh-huh.
It looks like Pocoyo has an idea. A rocket? Oh, I see. Well, then I'd better start a countdown. Ready?
3, 2, 1, blast off!
Well, look at that. It's a magical nighttime. See you soon. Hi, Elly. What are you doing? Painting? Of course. You're painting the house pink, a beautiful color. Oh, yes, very beautiful.
I mean, the most beautiful colour in the whole wide world. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hey!
Ellie's still got quite a lot to paint. Maybe she could use some help.
Paint!
I think perhaps she'd love some help.
Paint!
Well, Ellie, you've certainly made a very pink house. What's up? There, a nice can of pink. Pato, I'm afraid Ellie's not happy with your color. Ellie insists you paint the house pink.
No, blue.
Pato's painted your portrait on the wall. But Ellie, it can't be that bad to paint with other colours. A pink roof, Ellie. But Pocoyo. Oh no, Pato. Guys, maybe you should... Easy now, guys. Wait a minute. If you don't calm down, you'll never solve this. What a mess. Good idea, Ellie. Each of you can paint a part. Wonderful!
Hey!
it. Now the house is beautiful. See you next time. Slow down when you're approaching a traffic signal. What an amazing race. They all deserve to. This is the last lap. Nothing is decided. Pato is in first place. You didn't brake in time and have lost control. Let go of the accelerator when you approach a traffic signal. What a... Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Ah, building blocks. How nice. What's this?
Friend!
You've made some new friends? And they're so colourful!
Daddy!
There's a blue one, and a yellow one, and a green one, and a red one.
Wait, Pato, wait!
I see. You're going to show Pato.
Friends?
Where did they go?
Professor Pato.
Hello, friends. Welcome to another lesson with Professor Pato. Professor Pato says that when there's sun and rain, something wonderful appears. A rainbow. How lovely.
Rainbow.
Well done, Caterpillar. Baby bird, can you tell us what that's called? Can you help baby bird?
Rainbow!
It's a rainbow!
It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say. Wonderful! Now we've all learned about rainbows.
Lesson approved by Professor Potter.
Friend?
Still haven't found your friends, Pocoyo? There's one! He's right there! Can you tell Pocoyo what colour to look for?
Yellow!
There's one! What colour is that one?
Blue!
It's blue!
Now what colour?
Green! The green one!
Now what colour should Pocoyo look for?
Red! The red one!
Daddy! Daddy!
Number menu! Time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. One orange. Very good.
One orange!
Oh dear. Well, how about one slice of watermelon instead?
One slice of watermelon.
Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
One heart.
That's it, one. Look, Pato, these are Pocoyo's new friends.
Daddy, Daddy!
Wonderful! What colourful friends you have, Pocoyo!
Red, blue, yellow, green. Color. You got the colors. Red. Blue. Yellow. Green. Red. Blue. Yellow. Green.
Took a perfect photo. Hi, Elly. What's that? Oh, a new doll. It's beautiful. It's Pato and Pocoyo. They're painting. Elly says you should paint her doll. It's perfect. It has a nose, eyes, two eyes, ears, two ears, and a mouth. Okay, time to paint. The Martian Brothers Show! Pencil. Crayons.
Thank you.
Okay, Elly wants to see your paintings. Can you tell me what that is?
It's a nose!
A nose, right. Can you tell me what those are?
Eyes!
Two eyes!
Eyes. Poor Elly. Can you tell me what that is?
A mouth!
Good, a mouth. What are those?
Ears!
Two ears.
Ears. Elly doesn't look very happy.
Wheel of Colors! Welcome to the show! Today's color is... brown! Something brown. What can you find? See your pictures. A brown chest. A brown paintbrush. A brown door. Good! Keep searching for brown things. A brown suitcase. Perfect. A brown chair. Excellent. And this, do you know what it is? A brown teddy bear. Very good. Hooray for brown. Poor Elly.
Oh, you're going to try again. What's this? It's a big painting of your doll.
I love you.
Wonderful!
If we have just a pair of eyes, it's not a face. If we have just a pair of ears, it's not a face. If we have just a giant nose, it's not a face. If we have just a giant mouth, it's not a face. But if we have two ears and just one nose, and if we also have two eyes and just one mouth, then we have all the things that make a face. All the things that make a face. We have all the things that make a face. But if we have two ears and just one nose, and if we also have two eyes and just one mouth, then we have all the things that make a face. All the things that make a face. We have all the things that make a face.
It seems like Pato has a solution. Shall we help him? Good! You did it on the first try! What a great idea, Pato! With that giant broom, we will tidy everything up in no time! Bravo! You have collected all the blocks! Hello, Pato. A paintbrush. You're painting. Great. Yeah. Pocoyo has crayons. And you, Elly? A pencil. Terrific. Fruit. Ah, I see. You're painting a still life. Wonderful. Hello, baby bird. Can you tell baby bird what Elly is holding?
A pencil.
That's right. A pencil. Elly is drawing with a pencil. And what's that?
A paintbrush.
That's right. Pato has a paintbrush. And Pocoyo, what does he have?
Crayons!
He has a crayon!
Very good. Pocoyo has a crayon. Baby bird wants to be in the picture. Beautiful.
The Martian Brothers Show!
Notebook. Palette. Five strawberries. One. Good job, Pocoyo. Oh, dear.
Hey!
What a beautiful drawing, Elly. Oh, no. Baby bird, it's not nice to eat the still life. And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, spin! That's it! Spin around! Everyone spin! Spinning is fun! Fred says, giggle! Come on, let's giggle. That's it. Giggle. Giggling is fun. Fred says, walk. Walk. Everybody walk. Well done. Fred says, that's all. Now, baby bird, it's not that bad. What's this? Look at your friend's pictures. There's one in pencil, a lovely one in crayon, and a beautiful painting done with a paintbrush. It looks as if Baby Bird really likes your pictures. Hooray!
Yes, I like to paint something nice, something beautiful. I paint with my friends, each of us in a different way. You can use the palette and the paintbrush, the pencil, or maybe you prefer the crayons.
Paintbrush, palette, pencil, crayons, notebook.
You can use the palette and the paintbrush, the pencil, or maybe you prefer the crayons.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Ellie's got a pot on her hand. Oh, I see. She's doing a painting. That's a very unusual way to paint. What's that?
Monkey?
You think you hear a monkey? Can any of you tell Pocoyo if that's really a monkey?
It's not a monkey.
It's Baby Bird.
That's right. It's not a monkey. It's Baby Bird. And look. He's doing a painting too.
Excellent.
Fred is going to do a painting too. What are you going to paint? Oh, you don't know yet. I see. Pato, aren't you going to paint a picture? Maybe you will and maybe you won't. I suppose Pato doesn't think painting is much fun. Aha! Time for the big exhibition. There's Baby Bird with the party food. Yummy, how lovely. Ah, and here's Ellie's painting. What do you think of it, Pocoyo? This must be Baby Bird's painting. What's that, Pocoyo? You're trying to think of words that describe the painting. Ah, of course. Vibrant. Vigorous. Dynamic. Careful, Baby Bird. Don't get too excited. Oh, here's Fred's very fine work. Pocoyo wants to know what it's supposed to be, Fred. I see. Yes, of course. He says it's a scribble.
Oh.
Here's Sleepy Bird's painting. What do you think, Pocoyo?
Honest?
True.
Asleep.
Pato, you decided to do a painting after all. Can we see it? It's... what? Pato! You painted that? There's more! My goodness! have even more? Let's see them. You painted all these? They're amazing. Could you paint one for us now? Oh, come on, Pato. Everyone would love to watch you at work. Wouldn't you like to see Pato do a painting?
Yes! Go ahead, Pato!
You don't have the right materials. That's no problem. Here you go. A nice blank canvas. You're thirsty? There you go. All right, Pato, we're ready. Amaze us. Oh, dear. Pato, you didn't really paint those paintings, did you? Okay, here is what we're going to do. First, take those paintings back to where you got them from. Very good. Here's a nice blank canvas. Give it a try. All right, you don't like to paint. What do you like? Flowers! You're right, they are lovely, so why not paint them? No, but there's nothing to be afraid of. Look, Pocoyo's drawn a wonderful flower. Pato! You did it! You painted a painting! And it's a splendid one! That's fantastic! Now, aren't you glad you tried? Hooray for Pato! Hooray for trying something new! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hello, Elly. Oh, look! Elly has some very nice shoes. Hi, Pato! And Pato has a stylish hat and a bow tie. Wonderful! Oh, hello, Pocoyo. Wow, those are some trousers. Oh, I see. Our friends are playing dress up. What fun! The Martian Brothers Show! Sunglasses. Ribbon.
Ribbon, it's a ribbon.
Hello, Caterpillar. Can you tell Caterpillar what Elly is wearing?
Shoes!
Can you tell Caterpillar what Pato is wearing?
A hat! And a bow tie!
Can you tell Caterpillar what Pocoyo is wearing?
Trousers!
It seems Caterpillar wants to play dress up too. Oh my, that shoe is too big. That hat is too big too. Oh dear, and the trousers.
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
It's a frog!
Frog!
Very good! A frog! Poor caterpillar can't play dress up. What's that, Elly? You say caterpillar can wear Pato's bow tie? Oh, caterpillar! What a lovely ribbon! Hi, Pocoyo.
Hi.
What are those things?
Paintbrush, palette.
Oh, I see. You're painting. What a beautiful painting. Hi, Elly. What are you doing? You're taking pictures. Terrific. Hello, baby bird and caterpillar. What are you doing? You're making a sculpture. Wonderful. And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. A camera? A paintbrush?
Paintbrush!
palette. Now, Pocoyo. Well, good night.
Hello, Pato. Look, it's a museum. Can you tell Pato what that is?
A sculpture!
Right, a sculpture. You don't like it? Oh, dear. Can you tell Pato what that is?
A painting!
It's Pocoyo's painting!
Painting!
You don't like the painting? Can you tell Pato what those are?
Pictures!
Pictures. You don't like the sculpture, the painting, or the pictures?
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now, do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
It's a kangaroo!
A kangaroo! Pato, I think you hurt your friend's feelings. Well, maybe you can show them how to do it. What's that you say, Pato? It's too difficult? Elly says your painting is wonderful, Pato. You're all talented! Hooray!
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Ooh, what are you doing? Oh, that's wonderful, Pocoyo. Can any of you tell what Pocoyo is drawing?
It's a fish!
A picture of a fish!
Exactly, it's a fish. A green fish. And what a beautiful green fish it is. What are you thinking about now, Pocoyo?
More picture!
Oh, I know. How about a nice place for the fish to live? Hi, Pato. Have you seen what Pocoyo's drawing? What's wrong, Pato? Look at that! Can any of you see where that fish is?
It's in the sky!
Yes, it's a fish in the sky! How imaginative, Pocoyo! I don't think Pato has seen a fish that lives in the sky before. It must be a birdfish, a bish, or a fish bird, or a furred. Oh, never mind. What are you going to draw next, Pocoyo? A lovely blue fish. That's really very nice, Pocoyo. Oh, now, I wonder who that could be. I think Pocoyo wants to surprise you, Elly.
Ta-da!
Look at that! Can any of you see where this fish lives?
In the trees!
Well, that's wonderfully imaginative too, Pocoyo. Look at that fish go! It's quite the swinger, isn't it? Oh dear, I don't think Elly has seen a fish that lives in the forest before.
Another picture.
You're going to draw another picture, Pocoyo? I wonder what it's going to be this time. This is really fun. Oh, what a fantastic red fish. Well, I wonder where the red fish will live. Look at that! Can any of you see where this lovely red fish lives?
In the sea!
Yes, it's under the water in the sea. Oh yes, I suppose that drawing does show where fish really live. Wow! My goodness! Oh, I think Pocoyo is trying to tell you that he made those pictures for you, Pato and Elly. I suppose it just goes to show it's lots of fun when you use your imagination. What's this? A gift for all of us? Why, thank you, Pocoyo. It's lovely. Hooray for Pocoyo and his lovely pictures. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Red, blue, yellow, green. Color. You got the colors. Red. Blue.
Blue.
Yellow.
Yellow.
Green.
Green.
Red.
Red.
Blue.
Blue.
Yellow.
Yellow.
Green.
Green.
Hi, Elly. A house? How lovely. The door? The roof? The roof is on top of the house. And a window. Terrific. Hello, Pato. Hello, Pocoyo.
House.
A house, that's right. You must be very careful. It's Ellie's house. Now, Pocoyo, Pato, be careful. Oh, dear. Oh, this is bad. The Martian Brothers Show! Lamp. Phone.
Phone. It's a phone.
Can you tell Pocoyo and Pato what that is?
Roof.
Very good. Can you tell them what this is?
Door.
It's the door.
Door.
The door. Right. And what's this?
Window.
It's the window.
Window.
Right.
Rebuild.
Good idea.
This is not good. Poor Elly. Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
Snake! It's a snake!
Snake!
Yes, it's a snake. Well done. Better. The roof goes on top of the house. The window. The window goes there. Great! And the door. The door goes there. Perfect.
We did it! Yay!
What a beautiful house!
Yay!
We're going to build a house now. We're going to need some walls and a roof. We also need a door. And then we need a window.
It's true. Nina likes wearing green, and the nature's green, you know, like the leaves on the trees, and the apples and the pears when they grow. Red and blue, green and yellow, a color for everyone. Red and blue, green and yellow, all together we'll have more fun. Yellow.
There's Pocoyo, Pato and Elly. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Ah, it's a dressing up box. So, what do you think you'd like to do today? Do any of you know?
Dressing up.
Dressing up.
Ah, yes. What a good idea.
Story, story.
What's that? You would like me to tell a story? And you will all pretend to be the characters? Oh, that would be great fun. And I think it's safe to say that I'm rather a good storyteller. You all get ready now. Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom, there lived a brave young prince. Oh dear. Wait. The prince is the one who has a crown. Can any of you tell me which one of our friends is the prince?
Pocoyo!
Yes, it's Pocoyo. Sorry, boys. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. Now, this young prince was called Prince Pocoyo.
Hooray!
And he was very brave. And very handsome. And strong. Oh, and tall, of course. Yes. But this prince wasn't alone in his kingdom. Oh, no. There was also a beautiful elephant princess who had... No birds. Thank you, baby bird. Thank you. Anyway, she was without doubt the sweetest and most charming creature in the universe. So dainty and beautiful and strong. Yes, well that's very impressive, Ellie. I say, this isn't quite the story I was expecting to tell. But I think a weightlifting princess will work out very well indeed. Now, where were we? Ah, yes. This delicate and dainty elephant princess loved the prince. And the prince loved her. Ah, this isn't going so badly after all. But she was desperately sad because she couldn't go out to play with Prince Pocoyo because a crazy duck would not let her.
Boo.
He was a cruel and crazy... come on. Oh, do come on, Pato. You're supposed to be the baddie. Look, I promise you can be the prince next time, all right? Please? I promise. Good. So, this crazy duck was really cruel and crazy. More crazy? Just a little bit more crazy, Pato. Ah, that's perfect. Thank you, Pato. So, when he saw the young prince approaching, he decided to frighten him away forever with his fierce, terrifying, fire-breathing dragon. Yes! Who jumped towards the prince and started to kiss him. Oh, dear. Well, after this, the crazy duck was so furious, he sent his best warrior, the sleeping knight, and his terrible army. Hello again, baby bird. This time, Prince Pocoyo was surrounded. No escape. What could he do? Invite them all to a picnic? Why did I ask? and to have a little sleep in his bed? But Crazy Duck was really angry with him, so angry that he started to water his plants. And the Elephant Princess went for a ride on her scooter. Elly, Elly, but this is not a... And Prince Pocoyo played in his car. And the Crazy Duck bought himself a canary. And... Oh, wait a moment. Now I get it.
Yes.
Once upon a time, there were some great friends who just love playing together. What a wonderful story. Hooray for stories. And hooray for Pocoyo. Bye-bye. See you soon. What's behind it? Do you think Pocoyo should open it and find out?
Yes!
Open it!
A door to the sky? Now that's unusual. I wonder what happened to the sky. Yeah, I think Pato wants to keep watching the fish.
Pato?
can any of you tell Pocoyo where Pato went?
He went through the door.
Pato, there you are. Pocoyo is looking for you. Where's... Oh, Pocoyo, you just missed him. Pato! Pato, wait! Oh, dear. Pocoyo, I'm afraid you just missed him again. Oh, my. That is one strange door. Try again. Did you see him?
Pato?
Yes, he was just there. There he is again! Oh my! Another door! More doors? Oh dear! Now, Pocoyo, you can't give up. That sounded familiar. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who made that sound?
Pato!
I believe you're right. It sounded like Pato. Perhaps you ought to get some help, Pocoyo. Hello, Elly.
Pato, Pato!
Hooray! You found him! What's that, Elly? You're working on something? What could Elly be working on that's so important? That's what Elly was busy with. She was preparing a party. What?